happen. 3 years ago, we started unveiling the secrets of multi-platform game development.
Now, we didn't just want to show a trick or two. I mean, we wanted to completely blast open the vault to game development mastery. And little did we know that within weeks, you guys made us the top tutorial channel of game development. And because of the buzz that you created, we were able to extend our help to console developers, top app publishers, and hundreds of indie studios. But that was then. What we're about to do next will blow your mind. After opening about 300 emails a day for the past 3 years, we noticed that many studios have very innovative ideas for the action shooter genre, but not enough staff, or not the right staff, or not enough funds to pull it off.
Because as you know, the known shooters out there all cost about $30 to $60 million to pull off, with a staff of about 200 people over the span of 2 to 4 years. So how can we help you compete in that space?
Well, you asked, and we have the answer.
FPS Control is an ever-expanding suite of tools that allow you to build any first-person game in no time. It's built on top of the popular Unity game engine, so you can easily deploy your games to any platform. Rather than spending hundreds of hours coding artificial intelligence and gameplay elements, you can use the built-in editors to tweak the existing functionality for you. And if you'd like to go deeper, you can always get a source license to extend the existing codebase as well as build your own editors. So in short, do only what you like to do and still get an original game in a fraction of the time.
As a proof of concept, we wanted to see how quickly we can create a total different shooter with the same package. So what we did was we took a bunch of ancient characters and a bunch of swords, threw them in the system, and within less than 2 weeks, we had gameplay going. Now, this ancient battle arena game is a little rough around the edges still, and it's just a demo, but it does show you how quickly you can create something useful.
Yeah, in under 2 weeks. And if that isn't exciting enough yet, the basic version of FPS Control is completely free. So head on over to fpscontrol.com and download the copy that's waiting for you.
To make FPS Control work, let's install the software that we need. First, go to fpscontrol.com and then click on download. And this will guide you to the two steps that are needed to download all the software. First, we need the game engine, which is called Unity, which is what FPS Control runs on. Simply click the download button right next to it and it will bring you to the Unity page. Now click download Unity in whatever version number is the most recent one, and it will start downloading automatically. If you're on a Mac, it will start downloading the Mac version. If you're on Windows, it will start downloading the Windows version. Now, I've already installed Unity, so I'm going to cancel this. But make sure you've got Unity installed before you go to the next step. So let's close this and go back to step two. And in step two, we ask you if you want to receive your FPS Control download link. Now to do this, you need to put your email address in. And the reason why we ask you for your email address is because technology changes very, very quickly in this industry, and new versions come out very, very quickly. So we need to keep you updated on the most recent version. Of course, we send those updates out for free. So now, if I check my email here, an email will have come in saying that I should confirm my email address. I click the link to confirm my email address and it tells me, that's great, a new email will come in with the download link. So let me check my inbox again, and there it is. So if I open that up, it will tell me your subscription has been confirmed and here's your download link. So now I simply click on that link and it will start downloading FPS Control. Now, make sure you have Unity installed before you open this zip file. I have unzipped this file already so that you can take a look, and there's a folder called FPS Control when you unzip it. In that folder there are three other folders, Assets, Library, and Project Settings. I'd recommend that you leave Library and Project Settings alone because this is filled in automatically by the Unity engine. But in the Assets folder, it holds all the resources that our game needs, and we can implement 3D characters in here, scripts, and all kinds of cool stuff. So if we scroll down and go to the scenes view, in this folder we've chosen to keep all our levels or all our maps. So all you have to do to launch Unity in FPS control mode is clicking one of the files here, and let's open up shellshock.unity. And .unity files, obviously, a 3D level. And there we have it. We've launched our first game. So in the next video, we'll explain how all this works and what we can do next. So see you in the next one.